Google Merchant Settings availability dates. One of the latest updates that's going to start taking effect on June of 26, 2022 is the availability dates. In this video, I'm going to explain exactly who is this going to affect, this particular availability dates issue, and how you can resolve these issues to make sure your products continue showing up on the Google Shopping tab, whether you are doing advertising or it's for free. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps small businesses and online stores get more traffic and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. If you're new to this channel, you might be interested to check out some of my playlists on Shopify marketing playlists. And I also have a free download Shopify marketing guide that helps you to explore different ways of driving traffic to your store. In order to constantly provide a great experience for Google Shopping users, Google strives to continuously upgrade their process of how they are collecting the information from different online stores, whether you have a Shopify, WooCommerce. As long as you are selling products online, then you want to adhere to these guidelines and rules if you want your products to be listed for free or for Google Shopping ads. If you're an online store owner and you have been having your products shown on Google Shopping tab, whether it is for ads or just for free listings, you might have received one of these emails from Google Merchant. This is how it looks like. Basically, it says that from the June 26 onwards, you need to set an availability date. The gist is from June of 26 onwards, you need to set the availability dates if your products are listed either pre-order or back order. If your products are set to in-stock or out of stock, then you don't have to worry about it. But if you have products that you are run out of stock, or you have products that are new that you are planning to bring into your store, then you will need to also inform Google as part of your data feed that you are feeding into Google Merchant Center. You need to have the availability dates. I want to share some clear background or guidelines. There are four standard values that Google accepts for the availability column. In stock, what it means is if you have these products and you allow people to order online and you deliver to where they desire, that's where you put the products in stock. For that, you don't have to set an availability date. The next accepted value is out of stock. Out of stock basically means you don't have these products anymore, you're not accepting any orders, people can't order anymore, or maybe this is a product that you are planning to discontinue and you are not offering it for sale online anymore, then you can put out of stock. The third accepted value is back order. Essentially, back order means right now you don't have this product, but you allow people to order in advance, and when the products are available, then you send it to them immediately. In order to allow people to pre-order for existing products in advance, you need to populate this column called availability date. The accepted column name is availability underscore date. There are a certain number of ways of how you can set this up, which I'm going to explain in the next section, but I want to go back to the fourth accepted value, which is pre-order. Pre-order, the standard column name is pre-order joined together. This attribute is meant for if you have a new product that you're launching is not available on the market before, then you use this column. If you use the value pre-order, then you will need to put in when this product is available. When will it be available in stock if you want people to pre-order it? You need to put the date there. If your product's availability are either in pre-order or back order and you need to set a date, there is three different criteria you want to take note of. First, the date cannot be more than 1 year ahead of the current date. So if your product is available in 2 years' time, then forget about it. There's no need to even have this product in your system in the first place. You can exclude that because Google will not accept a date that is further than 1 year. The second thing is for this availability underscore date, you can choose to put in the date when it's going to become available. It's an accepted value by Google. And the third criteria is if you want to specify down to the date and time of when the product is going to be available, it's also possible. If you want to make your life easier, then you just put in the dates for now, because the formatting with the time could be slightly complicated. And if you want to add in even specific to the time zone of your country of sale in the first place, then this could also make your life difficult if you are not comfortable with formatting. So the best option is probably just to stick with the date. And there are three ways which you can set it up. The first way is you can go to Google Merchant Center account, and you can go to where you're setting up the rules attribute. You set up a special exception to set if you have product that is in pre-order status, availability, pre-order, you can set the date which you're going to have the products available. And this will automatically help you to submit the availability date to Google Merchant Center. This method itself is available if you have Shopify or WooCommerce store or any other commerce store. You can do this override itself within the Google Merchant Center for just a couple of products. It's the easiest, fastest way to do that. If you have multiple products that have different launch dates or back order or pre-order dates over the entire year, then maybe you might want to download multiple Google Shopping Feed app. So this allows you to keep track of the different availability for different items. You can set it up individually, so it's easier for you to keep track rather than method one, which I have recommended. There is also the third way, which I'm going to explain in a bit more detail, is you can create your own supplementary feed as well. Instead of using an app, you can create your own supplementary feed. You can create a CSV file or on a Google Sheet itself, and then you can put down the list of products with the product ID and the availability, and the availability date. You can submit it to Google Merchant on the Google Merchant Center, and this information will be combined with your existing automated feed that you have set up. So this information will be updated and it will be complete for Google. I'm going to head on to the computer to show you exactly how you can set it up. So let's head on to the computer.
First, you will go to Google Merchant Center under Feeds, and you have your primary feed, which is your automated feed set up. You click on that feed itself, it will bring you to this page, Settings, and you go to Feed Rules to start editing your rules. Click on Create Rule, as you can see here. Click on and select Availability Date. Right, to set the availability date for products that have a pre-order value, this is what you can do. You can set a conditions, select example, if your availability contains the value pre-order, okay, then you will set the availability date to, let's say, in 1st of July. So this is the number that you will get. And then you will click on OK. If the availability attribute is stated as pre-order, you will set the date to 1st of July. Another way which you can do it is if you want to set for specific items or products, this is what you can do. Okay. So we remove this, so we can set for example, if you have a specific product and you know the item ID, so the ID which is the Shopify ID unique for each specific SKU, ID, and if you know the SKU number, you will type in the value here. Let's pretend the SKU is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right, so for a specific product that has, that's labeled 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you are going to set the date to 1st of July, which you have set before, and then you click on OK. So for a specific product that has this ID number, you're going to set it to July 1st, and then you can click on save as draft. So it's going to go back to the main feed, and then you can click on apply. Once you click on apply, you will be updated to your automated availability date in your supplementary feed. within Google Merchant Center, you need to prepare the information in advance. You could set it up in the Excel file if you have a license to Microsoft Excel, or you can also easily set it up in Google Sheet. For this example, I'm using a Google Sheet. You open a new file and you give your file a name. In this case, I've put this name as setup availability date. Once that's set up, then I have the column name here. So I've put three column names here. This will be the column names that you will submit into the feed. So the first one is ID, which is the item ID. As I mentioned in the previous example, ID will be the unique identifier for each of your item. In this case, I've just come up with a number, which is called 1234567. And I also want to update another item that's called 2345678. Both these items will be available for pre-ordering. These are new products that will be launching on the 1st of July. There are two options which I can put it. Availability underscore date. You have to use the correct column name for the date, which is underscore date. And availability. And let's presume that this product will be available on 1st of July. So this will be the date you will be putting in this particular format. 2022-07-01, 1st of July. If you don't put any time, by default, this will be available by 12 o'clock, 1st of July, 12 a.m. UTC time. If you are really specific, you really want to go into this time zone, you can also choose to put here to say it will only be available specifically only at 9 a.m. 0900. So the T stands for time, and you put 090000. So this is the time and this is the date. You have to put in the T to symbolize the time on 1st of July, and you can go into the time zone as well. Over here, I've put 05, which is the New York time, minus 05, or if I want to put the UK time, which we are in British summer time right now, I will then put in plus 0100. If you're confused by this time zone, you know what? Just put the date. You will not go wrong with the date. It's fine. You're not holding a competition, so you don't exactly have to have that precise a date range. Even if the time is a bit strange, then guess what? Just put 2nd of July. Okay, it's not a showstopper. You are still allowing people to do their ordering, and these products will still be seen on Google Merchant Center, except they will have a pre-order status. So it's not a big deal to put that. Time zone is slightly confusing for most people, so just forget about that if it's too complicated. Once you have the file done, you can either set it up in Google Merchant Center, or you can download as a CSV file and upload to Google Merchant Center. So you can go over here, you can export and download a copy over here as a CSV file. Right, now we have the file ready. What you can do is you get back to your Merchant Center under feeds. Earlier on, we were modifying the rules in the primary feed over here. Now you want to add a supplementary feed. This method is useful if you have a list of products that have varying dates. By keeping them on a spreadsheet, it's easier for you to keep track of everything rather than to go into the rules, which can be complicated if you want to quickly look through them or review, or if there are any changes. So if you want to add a supplementary feed, supplemental feed over here, click on Add Supplemental Feed, click on it, it will bring you to a screen, and there are three steps for you to set up as an input setup, and it will integrate with the feed. You need to give your feed a name, whatever name works fine, doesn't matter. And if you don't want to upload a file, a CSV file, to the computer, you can also choose to link it to your Google Sheet, give it a name, and then let's say availability date, availability date. Then you click on Google Sheet. Then you click on Continue. It will bring you to log into your Gmail account. And once you click onto the Gmail, it will ask you which file you want to select. And you click on that file. And then you can set it up and add to your primary feed. It's pretty straightforward. And then you have it all done. Remember that this option is only available for products in the pre-order and back-order status.
And that's it. I hope that will help you to resolve any upcoming issue before June 26. If you are also facing other issues that are showing up as errors in your Google Merchant Center, for example, having an incorrect mismatch price and availability, you can check out my other video right here where I explain to you exactly what you can do with your settings. This one trick that will help you resolve your issues so you will always be submitting the latest correct information to Google Merchant Center. If you want to drive more traffic to your online store, whether it is Shopify, WooCommerce, Magento, or BigCommerce, you might also want to check out my marketing guide where I explain to you exactly what are the different ways that you can drive traffic to your store. And you can review those options and decide on the best marketing strategy to get more traffic and sales in 2022. If you require one-on-one support, I also help online store owners to get more traffic and sales with like different strategy, marketing strategy, whether it is a blogging strategy, YouTube strategy, or running ads to get more traffic in the middle to long term. You can check out my contact method down in the description and pinned comments below. And if you enjoyed this video and found it useful, remember to hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss future videos on how to get more traffic and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. I'm not the one who's always right.